Welcome to examples on how to find function values when we have a sum, difference, product, and quotient of two functions. Here we're given f of x and g of x and asked to find f plus g of negative 3, f minus g of negative 3, f times g of negative 3, and f divided by g of negative 3. If we take a look at the definitions given here below, notice how we can write each of these in terms of f of x and g of x, or in our case, in terms of f of negative 3 and g of negative 3. So let's begin by finding these two function values. So for f of negative 3, we'll substitute negative 3 for x into f. That would give us negative 3 squared minus 5 times negative 3. That would be positive 9 plus 15, which equals 24. So f of negative 3, equals 24. And then for g of negative 3, we would have 2 times negative 3 plus 1. That would be negative 6 plus 1, or negative 5. So we know g of negative 3 equals negative 5. So now to find f plus g of negative 3, we can rewrite this as f of negative 3 plus g of negative 3. So f of negative 3 plus g of negative 3. And we just found these two function values. This would be 24 plus negative 5, which is equal to 19. So f plus g of negative 3 equals 19. And now for f minus g of negative 3, we would have f of negative 3 minus g of negative 3. And again, we already found these function values. F of negative 3 is 24 minus g of negative 3 is negative 5. This would be 24 plus 5, or 29. So now we know that f minus g of negative 3 equals 29. F times g of negative 3 is equal to f of negative 3 times g of negative 3. And again, we already have these function values. This would be 24 times negative 5, which is negative 120. So f times g of negative 3 equals negative 120. And then finally, f divided by g of negative 3 is equal to f of negative 3 divided by g of negative 3, which would be 24 divided by negative 5, or just negative 24 fifths. We should check, but this does not simplify. And therefore, f divided by g of negative 3 equals the fraction negative 24 fifths. I hope you found this helpful.